A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th October, Sunday. On the front page, you have Summit will usher in a new era in India-China relations, says Prime Minister Modi. So both sides have agreed to set up a high-level economic and trade dialogue mechanism on the sidelines of the summit which took place, the informal summit which took place in Chennai. And this is postpaid mobile phones to ring again in Kashmir. So restoration would take place to help 40 lakh such mobile phones, postpaid mobile phones, not the prepaid ones. So they would be restored from 14th October after 71 days of communication shutdown in Kashmir Valley. But then it has been warned that wide-scale militant attacks being orchestrated from across the border is a threat which still persists. Then below you have parliamentarians want to ditch BSNL, MTNL over poor services. So parliamentarians are provided these BSNL, MTNL phones. So poor network connectivity and call drops have resulted in several MPs keen to drop their official telecommunication providers. So this has become a concern. You can see there are three private operators in the country: Airtel, Vodafone and Reliance. All MPs are provided three mobile connections, one of which can be used for broadband services. And as per housing and telephone facilities rules, local calls are 50,000 local calls are free each year for MPs. Then below you have government transparency eliminating need to file RTI. So this is Modi government is said by Amit Shah on 14th anniversary of RTI Act. He says Modi government is so transparent that it is eliminating the need for RTI. There are no RTI requests. A large number of RTI applications does not indicate the success of a government, is what he says. And he says we want to introduce a system where people do not feel the need to file an RTI. So such are the statements being given. The biggest change in the RTI law, which happened in July 2019, is the RTI Amendment Act, through which both houses of parliament gave itself the power to set the tenure and salaries of state and central information commissioners. So the autonomy of the Central Information Commission and State Information Commission is diluted. The independence is no longer persists. So autonomy is threatened. And he says there is no need for RTI. Even the government has not framed rules after amending the act. So no commissioners can be appointed anywhere in the country until that is happening. So appointments are not happening. There are pendency of cases. Even one of the activists has approached the Supreme Court. And she has sought intervention to ensure implementation of the order of the central government directing the center and states to immediately fill the vacancies in the Central Information Commission and State Information Commissions. On page 9, you have Supreme Court treats softly on errors by judicial officers. So Supreme Court has cautioned high courts against taking disciplinary action against judicial officers merely on the ground that they had passed wrong judicial order. The bench said that to err is human. And it has asked high courts in a recent judgment to go soft on erring judges. Then on page 10, you have 8 injured in Srinagar blast. So this is suspected militants who hurled a grenade when scores of people were busy shopping in Srinagar. So it is a commercial hub here, Hari Singh High Street, where this blast took place, in which 8 civilians were injured. On page 11, you have Saying It With Silk, a Srimugai shawl for Z. So this is a special portrait shawl designed and woven in Coimbatore. So you should know the culture aspect of it too. This has been gifted to visiting Chinese Premier Xi Jinping. So it's a gold and red silk shawl with his image. So you should know about this Srimugai shawl. On page 11, you have Saying It With Silk, a Srimugai shawl for Xi. So this is a gift which India gave to Chinese President Xi Jinping. It is a silk shawl, a red and golden shawl with his portrait on it. So it is Srimugai shawl from Coimbatore. So you should know about the culture aspect of it too. And this is Tamil Nadu Fujian to be sister states. So India and China, after the second informal summit in Chennai, which is now being called Chennai Connect, have decided that the two states would be connected, that is Tamil Nadu of India and Fujian province of China. So sister relations will be, sister state relations will be established between the two. On international page, you have US-China inch closer to trade deal. So a pact between the two may is likely, which will cover agriculture, currency, and even some aspects of intellectual property protections. And this is Islamic State rears its head. So after the Turkish invasion in Syria, fear of Islamic State-led attacks, militants is there, and militants are escaping. So concerns have been raised here. So you should know about this Turkish invasion in Kurdish-held territory in northern Syria. So, you know, five militants escaped from the Kurdish-run prison, and the extremist group claimed responsibility for a bomb that exploded in the regional capital. Then there's no important news on business page. And then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So important issues throughout the week are covered in detail here. So first here is scandal to controversy regarding the Nobel Prize in Literature. In 2019, we had two Nobel Prizes announced for 2018 and 2019 as well. So what was the controversy last year? It was prominently in news amongst the jury, a sex scandal which had emerged and resulted in no literature Nobel being announced. So you should know about it. And this is how oxygen levels affect cell metabolism. So it says, will the discoveries that won the Nobel Prize for Medicine help in fight against anemia and cancer? So that is what it is said, when oxygen levels are low, how the body responds. So that mechanism, understanding that mechanism, can help fight diseases. So how does that happen, and what is its significance? It's detailed out here. We had discussed about it, how RBCs are formed when oxygen levels are low through erythropoietin. Then this is Unraveling the Secrets of the Universe. So this is regarding Physics Nobel Prize. So how the Physics Nobel Prize winners answered some of the age-old questions, that are we the only ones or on other exoplanets? Are there people living on other exoplanets? So understanding of our universe and our solar system, about our universe as such in general, about other planets. So is there life elsewhere? That question can be answered through the, is, you know, efforts have been made to answer that question through the discoveries which have been made by Nobel Physics Prize winners. And this is regarding Chemistry Nobel. So that is the lithium-ion batteries. So it says, towards a rechargeable world. So how the lithium-ion batteries, which won for its developers the Chemistry Nobel, set off a technology revolution. So their significance is discussed here. So it is Literature, Physics, Chemistry and Medicine Nobel Prize covered in FAQ. Then on Science and Technology page, which is a coverage on Sundays, you have your dark DNA. So researchers have discovered a new type of mutation of the non-coding part of the genome that can cause cancer. So this is called dark matter of human cancer, the DNA, which is very difficult to study. And this is NPL synthesizes, that is National Physics Laboratory, synthesizes novel security ink. So this two-pigment dispersion glows red under UV light and emits green color soon after the light is turned off. And under ambient light, this is how it looks. So this is phosphorescence. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage, where international news from other countries is covered. So this one is on Brazil. It says, Afro-Brazilians face eviction as government seeks to expand a missile launch site for the USA in the region. This is called Alcantara region in Brazil. So this has caused a concern here. And this is regarding Sri Lanka reconnecting Jaffna to southern India. So Alliance Air is launching direct flights from northern Sri Lankan city to Chennai and Tiruchi. So Jaffna, which was earlier under LTT control. So this direct flight is being launched now. But then these are not important news items from my exam perspective. Even this is regarding Pakistan, how religious party leader is launching a march to Islamabad to bring down Imran Khan government. Again, not relevant. This is power of Siberia warms China-Russia ties. So this is important. This is a 4,000 kilometer long gas pipeline from Russia's Far East to China, which will be launched in December 2019. So this one news is important. Then you have after dispatches sports coverage, and on the last page you have new research seeks to salvage infected donated organs. So Canadian scientists are attempting to deactivate viruses before transplant surgeries. So if donated organs get infected with virus or such, then they can be disinfected and then can be used as such. So yes, research is going. Canadian scientists are attempting this. And this is GM cotton seeds approved as food by US regulator. So the developers say it could be used to tackle malnutrition. GM cotton as food, which can be eaten. So that is it. And this last news is regarding extinction revolution, the climate change protests. So, you know, so what during climate protests, what will happen? So that is detailed out here. You can see extinction rebellion activists rehearsing blocking a street as such in Berlin. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.